Now the question is, how long until... Well, two questions really. How long until this thing, Hitbox, can show me his life again? And how long until that thing outside shuts the fuck up? Yes, I'm going to... Oh yes, here we go. So, fun story. The power cut out for half a second and everything shut down, so I had to restart. And now that stupid alarm outside is going off for no reason, like it does every time the power cuts out. Should open a new window. Putting this the same size I had it before. Don't know if I should. Let me see, like this. Yes, that will do. And if I recall, I made a... At least I did make a save pretty much immediately after, or before, going through the barrels. Or not quite, actually. I made a save right before jumping here. So you know what, I think I'm gonna go ahead and mute the microphone until that thing shuts up. Since I've already talked over this part a bit, so... And I resent that thing outside greatly, so I'm gonna shut up until it shuts up. Alright, it finally shut up. Don't even know why they have that. I don't think... Having an alarm that only activates when the power cuts out and doesn't activate when it cuts out, but rather when it returns, makes any real sense. But at least it lets me know pretty much that power cut out for half a second, not just for me, but for everyone. I can feel that sense of solidarity and bullshit happening. But now I can proceed. Oh boy. Proceed, and with any luck get to run these guys over like I didn't quite get to last time. And this time it didn't instantly cause a crash, or the power cutting out rather. Which in turn leads to everything shutting down immediately, alright. Well, having killed those guys, apparently we can also find another cache over there. In this vent, this grate that's marked with a symbol. And apparently the way to get up there is by using a barrel. I'm getting to the end of this pipe. Oh, where are these guys waiting to? Which I did not know. And there's also a skull, which you don't see a lot of. Or the upper part of a skull, at least. So let's go back across. And continue. I should probably make the obvious window visible too. Here we go. And this, make sure I'm looking at the right thing. This is the best place to get stuck. I think it's time to just try to rush through everything. How the barnacle managed to do that, but alright. I thought it was going to take the whole thing. But no, I guess it somehow managed just to be selective. So before long we should come under fire from something else. Now I'm just trying to get some bridges. I think we might have to disembark soon, and yes, I'll take care of things here to open up the gate up ahead. So we'll take care of a quick on foot section. Charcoal being kind of a pain. Direct confirmation of disruptor in our midst. Barnacle has acquired an almost messianic reputation in the minds of certain citizens. His figure is synonymous with the darkest urges of instinct, ignorance, and decay. Some of the worst excesses of the Black Mesa incident have been laid directly at his feet. And yet, unsophisticated minds continue to imbue him with romantic power. Giving him such dangerous poetic labels as the one free man, the opener of the way.
Right.
Let me remind all citizens of the dangers of magical thinking. We have scarcely begun to climb from the dark pit of our species' evolution. Let us not slide backward into oblivion, just as we have finally begun to see the light. If you see this so-called free man, report him. Civic deeds do not go unrewarded, and contrarywise, complicity with his cause will not go unpunished.
All right.
Be wise. Be safe. Be aware.
I guess that's all of it. Also, we got apparently lots of ammo for something. That's something being grenades. Alright. Hmm. 10 more grenades. And someone who got apparently a burnt face there. Oops. No, that's what I want. And then coming under fire from a lot of guys. Once. And apparently Mad Hacks too. Oh boy. There they are. I can't pretty much see them now. And sure enough. Right. that. I don't think that's all of them, though. Oh, what? But apparently that's immediate danger past. Well, even more grenades. You know, I should probably be using those. Since I have unlimited access to them right now. Don't know how far I can throw them, though. Apparently not very. I would try going up, advancing a little more. But first I need to not die. Just realize that that's a mounted gun. That probably doesn't help things. Oops. Well, that didn't work out. Pain, but apparently not death. There we go. Now do we get to use that? Maybe. I guess not. Oh boy. I do have a few people here, I see. Even more unlimited grenades, from what I see. And much needed healing. So, having come all the way here, can we figure out why we did? Open the gates, but can we open the gates? Oh yeah, here we go. Oh wait, can't use that, what? How are we to do this then? Do we need to find another one? Because we kinda need to open that, I mean. What if I drop one of these right here? I don't remember how to do that. There we go. That doesn't really do anything. You know, I don't remember if that's what I actually have to do. What we actually have to do to get this to work. I guess I'm gonna have another look at the other part of this place. So I could have sworn that we would actually have to use that mounted gun at some point. We got anything else in here right now? Oh. That's a camera, isn't it? Yep. Because you can find more things in here. Hmm. Well, I don't know. Maybe you're not supposed to just try to use it, but rather... Can't use this either. But rather you have to use it differently now. Also... I've been unable to see the chat for a moment. Alright, here we go. Hello, Zero. Oh, the barrels. Yeah, maybe that could have something to do with it. Oh, there we go. That works. I did not notice those barrels before. But here we are. I'm pretty sure we are gonna have to use the mounted gun now. So let's hurry up. Is that all of them? I didn't think there it was. But I guess it is. So let's see. Let's try to figure out how that guy hasn't died yet. Okay, that guy has another gun. Mounted gun. Okay. Come on. There we go. Oops. Maybe I should have left some of the pickups for later, but... Well, I think I did, anyway. Should be like a health thing, yeah. But I didn't pick up because I... Already had too much of that. Okay. And there might be another health regeneration thing nearby, but I don't know. I don't remember the helicopter that chases you through a big part of the stage being a big deal. However, also, hang on, I need to make that visible. And there we go. And keep going. Okay, we can... I think I missed the crate back there. I want everything I can get right now. Oh boy. Alright, we got an armored car shooting rockets at us right now. But we keep moving, so it's no trouble at all. And I'm trying to run those guys over, but apparently not being very good at it. Right, here's the second one. And if I'm right... Oh god, running right into the rockets. But right here there's a lambda symbol, so there should be something to get. Yes, here we are. If I can just get through. There we go. Oh boy. But apparently it was a surprise if we got for a way to get that. Oh boy. And I'm not going the right way, I've just realized. Just need to go sideways here. Oh boy. Now we made it past the open now, I guess we have for the moment. So let me see. Yes, I am going for all the lambdas right now.
I do have a list of them on the side. Should be another one close by, I believe. Yep, there's one. So I need to figure out how to get to it. Well, there are bricks holding this thing down. Because that one. Oh, there we go. That's a cache. Needs to be counterweight. Now let me see where the next one is. Oh. There should be something important nearby. That's another gate impeding our progress. So it's time to kill even more. No, there we go. Oh hey, we got the Magnum. I forgot that to get here. Oh, but I'm still gonna use the most numerous ammo for situations where it's really easy to do so. Dodging section here, or cover, should I say. One of these fuckers shooting at me from the sides. And apparently they can deploy manhacks like that. They did not remember that. No way. No, there is a way to run faster, I forgot. You need to shoot before you can do it though. Which is why it didn't work in the beginning. Surprised that they didn't put more of those caches in these on foot sections. Apparently, accentuating is hard. Alright, should be clear now. Oh, shit. Nope, we're not clear at all. You know what? I need more precision for this. There we go. Okay, now we're clear. In immediacy, at least. Oh boy. Time the helicopter's still out there. I should probably switch the windows around again so that I can actually see the chat for once. There we go. Hmm. Okay, who else we got down there? Hey, I need this. I see you out there too. Actually, let me get these two. I probably have stuff inside that I can use. There we go. And we get one of these chargers for once. A lot rarer than the health chargers, it seems, so far. Oh, shit. Okay, where did it go? There it is. Actually, if I recall, I don't remember if it's in this section or what, but well, no, it's actually two separate things. Well, once we finally get to the end, which this is one of them, and we've been chased by one of these helicopters the whole time. Once we get here, we do get to open the gate, but not only that. Once we see where it is, we actually get to do this. But apparently it gets away. And I think it might be back. Is correct. And after all that, we can finally get a shortcut back to where we need to go, which is the boat. And in this next section, there should be. Oh boy. Yep, there it goes. Assuming it's the same one, not a different one. Should be something on this bridge over. Oh boy. Not what I want, namely another hidden thing that I need to get out of the boat for. Before I continue, I do need to make sure where the next one is. Okay, let's see if we can do this. If we can dodge the mines, which we pretty much didn't even have to since. Since we pretty much just got away from the whole thing. And we're gonna be chased by this helicopter for a while. Really subtitle every sound effect? It would imagine so. It would appear so, rather. Oh boy. Well, it's over there, so I guess you don't have to go that way. Or maybe we do, because I don't see how we'd proceed in this direction. Ooh. Well, now we're chasing it while it's doing kind of obstacles. And apparently have a longer reach than would be expected. Get through this without too much incident. Hence, it's actually a lot worse when it starts shooting rather than dropping these things. Apparently, we're kind of getting hurt, but it's very marginal damage. Also, for some reason, when you like slow down and try to turn, it turns in the opposite direction from what you want. Okay. Oops. Perhaps that didn't blow up. Okay, right here. There is something else. Oh boy. Oh, rush. Okay, I guess we made it. For more machine gun fire. Should be something else nearby, I believe. In one of these places. Well, that one pretty much blew up immediately. I hope I didn't go past the one I was looking for, or I am looking for, I guess. I think this is the one. If we somehow are able to get up there. Hang on, let me see if I can get down. I can find this. This next one, which is not really marked clearly, but just by the graffiti it would seem. Should be yet another one, I believe. Yep. In this hidden dark section. And that's all the urgent ones we need to look for. Okay. Well, we didn't quite make it up there. I have a feeling I'm gonna have to try again. It would seem so. So let's try this one more time. And this time, let's try to steer in the right direction. The right direction. There we go. Ooh. Okay. Oh, shit. I'll try to heal without this thing getting in our way. How well that works. Oh boy. Hmm. Let me see, do I need to bring this thing down? I guess so. And now I can just go over. Go over to the next part. Oh boy. And apparently get airbombed from the distance and have one of those giant chimneys fall. But not right on me at least. Okay, that doesn't quite work. I'm guessing this will be the way. Oh boy. And apparently a rocket came down from somewhere. But before too long, I believe we should get to a better section. First, we need to figure out how to get past this one right here. Oh boy. Apparently, by or not by, by just standing on it. Need a brick. I just feel like it would be heavy enough. A chair. Make it heavy enough or to go wherever we need to go. Maybe we need to go up instead. I don't remember how to. Need past this, I will say that. Does look like we need to get above, maybe from over here. Oh yeah, there we go. I guess we jump down into the platform from all the way up here and then maybe. No, that doesn't work either. Well, maybe we just need to dump more stuff down there into it. Machine, maybe we just push it down below. There we go. Oh man, that sounds painful, Redder. I guess we need to get a little more of a running start if we're going to do this though. Well, that didn't work. Well, maybe if I start from over here. Or I go far enough that I accidentally load an earlier area. That's why the helicopter's still shooting. Hmm.
Damn it. Apparently, this with that center too, so that doesn't help. Okay, let's try this one more time. No, apparently that didn't. What the hell? Okay. There we go. But we don't need to make it into this pipe, but rather to find which way is way ahead. Which apparently we finally reached.
Dr. Gordon Freeman himself.
Time, Doc. We gotta move out before the combine picks us up. We're just getting ready to pull out.
All right.
We better hurry. We gotta tear down this camp and get out of here.
I do want to see what you have to offer me first, though. Alright. I see you got a magnifying glass.
Here, take a look at this.
Alright.
This here is the dam. It's just up ahead. Eli's hideout is here, a stone's throw from the apron and nestled in the old hydro plant. But getting there, with that hunter chopper on your ass, next to impossible. Good news is, the Vortigaunt's working his magic on your airboat, so you'll have a little more firepower going forward. I think he's just finishing up now. Go on out.
All right.
There we are. That gun came off one of the same hunter choppers that you're up against. I always like to bring a little irony into a firefight. Take that chopper down, and you should be able to tear on through to Eli's place.
Okay.
This weapon will suffer greatly on the road ahead.
So, after all this time, looks like we're finally armed. So, and it has pretty much unlimited quickly regenerating ammo, so we can pretty much finally go and do away with the, this fucker now. Or try to. But I need to do better at concentrating fire, I guess. Am I gonna find the secret alien? I don't know. I guess I could, but I already have the achievement for doing that. Actually, wait a minute. Before I proceed, I think there's like one more lambda thing. There we go. Pretty sure I know where it is now, so let's... make short work of the people here. Or the cops, I see. Which clearly are not synonymous with each other. I guess we don't actually have to open anything, just make it make our way through. Oh boy. Can we do away with the armored truck? Something tells me we cannot. But it's not even worth it anyway. So finally we can get through this whole section with a lot more peace of mind.
what, I would presume would be one of the final areas of this chapter. Okay, I didn't realize I could actually shoot that thing down. Wasn't really expecting to succeed there. Alright. Actually, I think the G-Man was supposed to be in one of these bridges, but... But I didn't catch sight of that. I do know, however, that if we take one of these paths, we will find another cache. Should be the last one for this level. There's a headcrab. Or a headcrab guy, at least. Got and more headcrabs. All over the place. Get the cash. I didn't. No, there it is. It's the actual one. And we are at 18, which I believe means we've pretty much gotten all of them so far. Or we better have. Right, I see we need to use gravity to defiance. I don't quite remember how this is supposed to work. Guess we just rush them through. To kill anything with a gravity gun except like headcrabs. Oh boy. I'm getting memories about this place being kind of tricky. And I don't remember if we can actually do anything about that thing up there. Or we just have to accept that it's there and try to work despite its two things. And we got a medkit at some point. I think we need to get onto these bridges somehow, or platforms. Can't remember how though. We can try to get into this place if Gordon Freeman will get out. Alright, here we go. Oops. can just try to deal with that on foot. If we actually get the... opportunity to do that. Which I honestly don't remember if I do. Alright. Can't even tell what they're trying to do there. What route they're trying to use, are we? Well, we can get through there, but I assume we need to get the speedboat through as well. I don't think this works. Actually, I don't think we're supposed to get there on foot. I think we're supposed to do something about those armored cars. Maybe it's on this side? Nah, I don't think so. I think you would have seen it. I'm really vulnerable here. Kind of in the dark right now. As I was before. Can I just, oh, never mind, you can blow those things up with the tow cannon. So I guess I will, even though. That leaves me pretty lifeless and still in the dark, even after that. I know there's a low health warning. Thank you, suit. Something to help me with that here? Yes, there is. Alright. Well, I need to get up there so I can use the ramp to get through there. But I have no memory of how to accomplish that to get the... the bridges. So it's time to inspect things, I suppose. Maybe I just shove my way through here. No, not quite. Kind of looked like it was going to work for a moment, but maybe not. Let's see, I'm over here, I would presume. We can get up there, though. But we do need the speedboat to proceed, well. Maybe get behind the boat. Ship. Oh, minor fracture, yes. Now that doesn't really help. How do you get onto the pier, though? That's what I'm trying to find out. Oh boy, I think I might be stuck. I don't know if I can get out here. Oh, never mind, yes I can. Doors in that crate. Oh, what? I can get through the crypt. Okay, I didn't think I could. Oh well, at least now I know. So that's it. Oh boy. And then we are somehow flipped over. But it's not a detriment at all. I think there's going to be another helicopter confrontation pretty soon. If this terrain reminds me of anything. Oh yeah. Well, I didn't realize that those should blow up just by going over them. Oh boy. I wish I could move. Apparently that thing does not actually drop. Rockets, like I thought it was going to, but rather just stuff on fire. Oh boy. I need to be able to face it somehow so I can actually do something against it. No, is it going to die, or... Oh god. Oh god. What do I need to do more? Oh boy. And here it comes again. Apparently it lasts for a long time. And I wish I could find more healing stuff. But I can only find explosive barrels apparently. Oh boy. Okay, I think it finally went down. That took long enough. And now we're at the zone where we can find the secret alien. Which I might. I can remember the details just how. Well, we need to open this gate, but to open this gate, we do need to get up there if I recall. Like this. Which is kind of weird because I think I remember like there being a ladder leading up there, but it's on the other side. But there's a ladder here that leads to the other side. All right. Right, there we go. Oh, there it is. Good. Looks like that guy might be spotting out a little. Just for the dialogue, but why not? And the secret alien should be over there in one of these things, which is barely accessible. I think you might actually need to bring something over it, but okay, maybe not. You have to sacrifice some of your own well-being to find this guy.
We remember the free man. We are Coterminus.
And there are dead fast headcrabs in here. I guess we can get healed back up at the place. And there's an achievement for finding that guy, but there is no longer a need for that. So we just hope that we are able to survive the toxic waste that we must traverse to get there. And get back over there to get refreshed. More. Oh well. And there we go. And there's kind of these guys with green pants, apparently. Green track pants. Sticking out of the door. So let's see. Oh yeah, that's the way back actually. So we're not supposed to go that way. But rather. Actually, I'm not sure anymore. I guess we go back up there. Because there's still that big part of the left that we haven't looked at yet. And there's more people there. And there's another gate. Well, I thought there were more people here. Ladder there so that it's easy to climb back up there from the other side. And over there we go. Oh boy. Ah, that's what the ramp is for. Alright. So, after getting past it, okay. Make it to the next stage, and that means that I need to have a look at this to make sure I don't miss anything. So this is pretty much a quick kind of a type stage, and there's no actual cache for that symbol. And we've made it here though.
Okay, it's human. Hello? Take it easy in there. You're safe now. But you'll have to forgive the scanning process. We can't take any chances. Dr. Freeman? Gordon Freeman? Is that you? You've made it here this quickly. Well, Eli is going to be amazed, not to mention relieved. I'm Dr. Mossman, Dr. Judith Mossman. I've been hearing about you since long before the Black Mesa incident. Oh, Black Mesa. I do so envy you working with Eli and Dr. Kleiner when they are at the top of their field. Ah, there we go. You can come through now.
Okay.
Eli right away. He would never forgive me if I kept you waiting.
So we made it to this guy's base. What we couldn't teleport to before.
Certainly use the extra help around here. We've covered a lot of ground in the last few months, but things could be so much faster if we had more people with your trip.
Alright.
We're closing in on a reliable local teleport technology. Except the Combine still hasn't mastered. Eli thinks their portals are string-based, similar to our Calabi-Yau model, but they failed to factor in the dark energy equations. They can tunnel through from their universe, but once they're here, they're dependent on local transportation. If they knew what we were doing with entanglement... Oh. Listen to me, I sound like a postdoc. I'm just so excited to think that we'll finally have the chance to work together. Where was I? Oh, yes. Dr. Kleiner compressed the Zen relay far beyond anything he imagined at Black Mesa. We've figured out how to use Zen as an unexpressed axis, effectively a dimensional slingshot, so we can swing around the border world and come back in local space without having to pass through.
All right.
Oh, here's Eli now.
So apparently the reason Zen was so important in the first game was because apparently it uses a relay for teleporting. Never really understood that. Let me get a look. But apparently that's the case.
My God, you haven't changed one iota. How do you do it? Now let's see. The last time I saw you, I sent you up for help after the resonance cascade. I never thought it would take you this long to get back to me. Welcome to the lab anyway. It's not Black Mesa, but it served us well enough.
It's going to be a lot more like Black Mesa with Gordon here to help.
Right you are. MIT graduates are few and far between these days. We'll get you out of that hazard suit and back into your lab coat where you belong.
Let me just finish up some work and I'll see what I can dig up. Dr. Freeman, it's been a real honor. I'm looking forward to working together.
Feel free to look around.
All right, I don't think we can go into this store once
oh,
she...
Dr. Freeman, you should stay with Eli. Go on, I'll rejoin you shortly.
Close it. But apparently the Vortigaunts are cooking.
Apparently they have a dedicated kitchen facility here. I'm trying to block the door with something.
I have a few things to attend to, Dr.
But apparently I didn't manage to. Oh wait.
Dr. Freeman? I figured you and Eli would want to talk about old times. We can talk later.
I'm determined to make this unclosable. Nope.
Fine scientist, Judith. She was up for your job at
Damn it.
You edged her out with your Innsbruck experience.
Alright. So what are we doing here now? Guess that's Alex.
I would blame you if you didn't volunteer for the next trial run.
And once again, I'm not sure what all of this is for. Oh, here we go.
Said you were here. I can't believe you made it so quickly on foot.
I believe he broke your record, honey.
Well, he earned it. I guess you proved you can handle yourself out there.
There's nothing Gordon can't handle, with the possible exception of you.
Dad, please.
Okay, so just sitting around here, I suppose. It's okay. Well, I'm looking at it. I'm not sure what I'm looking at, but...
Relieve me so I could come see Gordon. Anyway, I should be in here working on the portal.
I have the repairs well in hand. Someone misjudged the capacity of the Combine Thyristor.
Are you blaming me?
No, not at all. It was a calculation error, not a mechanical problem.
Then maybe you should let me do the calculations next time, as well as installing it.
Alex, really? Sometimes I think you deliberately misunderstand me.
Alex! Why don't you take Gordon along and give him some practice with the gravity gun?
Sure. Come on, Gordon. Let's go have some fun.
The zero-point energy field manipulator is not a toy, Alex.
Ugh. Let's get out of here.
Okay. So it's time to introduce the gravity gun. Which is kind of a...
So I see you've met Dr. Mothman. She's one of the main reasons I spend so much time outside. You should hear her drone on about how it should have been her in the Black Mesa test chamber that day. I'm sorry, I shouldn't be talking behind her back. It just gets a bit claustrophobic down here. That's the only
Which is a pretty... kind of a staple for the next chapter. Which we will have to go there for.
Come on.
So I'll go on. Oh boy, let's hang on a bit more for these loading sections now for some reason.
Scrapyard. This is a gravity gun my father was talking about. You can call it the zero-point energy field manipulator if you really want to. It's designed for handling hazardous materials, but we mainly use it for heavy lifting. Give it a try.
All right.
The trigger emits a charge. You can punch stuff and send it flying.
So I can pretty much use this too. Haul things around really easily. And indeed, if we haul things around enough that we can get up here and not fall.
Secondary trigger lets you grab things. You can throw them with the primary
find the classic HUV panel. And magnum rounds. And we get an achievement for finding that thing as well. Essentially grabbing them and more agitating them.
See if you can stack some stuff to climb up here.
I think I already did. I guess that wasn't enough though.
Alright.
Alright. Dwarf dog. Well, there is a dog.
Now let me call Dog. He loves to play fetch. Dog! Come!
And there it is.
Good doggy! Gordon, this is Dog. My dad built him to protect me when I was a kid. First model was about yay high. I've been adding to him ever since. Haven't I, boy? Okay, Dog, let's play catch with Gordon. You'll need to use the gravity gun.
Alright. I'm pretty sure that's an achievement for getting one of the... certain things through that hoop up there. Things that I guess have not shown up yet. How many of this are there in there? It's apparently an unlimited amount.
Excellent. Dog, go get your ball.
Or maybe it was the ball. Alright. I forgot that. That was a thing. And there he goes. Which is, I'm pretty sure, supposed to be a modified version of a certain obstacle that will come up before long on the highway level. And it can be pretty tricky to get that thing through the hoop. But apparently I already got the achievement for it, so I'm not really gonna bother that much. This your son rabbit. I guess just to get used to how the gun works.
I told you dogs like to play fetch. I didn't tell you who'd be fetching it.
So, why don't you go over there? Just watch. Oh boy. Alright. And apparently he's run out of things, so.
No, no boy. Down. Put that down. What is it, Dog? Oh my god, what was that? Scanners! Oh, combine.
No boy. So that didn't last very long, that period of tranquility.
Dad! Alex, do you read?
Alex!
What's going on in there?
Where are you, Alex?
We're in the scrapyard airlock, stuck in a full auto cycle.
Is Gordon still with you?
He's right here.
Good. I want you to...
Dad?
Take Gordon out of here. Head for the coast. Do not go through rape.
Dad? Damn it! Dog, open the airlock. Get us out of here. Hurry, now! Tear it apart if you have to. Get it open! That's enough, dog. Come on, Gordon. Come on!
No, apparently we cannot follow through.
I can't leave my father. Dog, take Gordon to the Ravenholm tunnel, then circle around and try to meet up with me. Hurry!
Well, apparently there's some action going on behind there, but apparently we have to go through the tunnel that we were pretty much told not to go through. Or this next chapter of the game. Well, the gravity gun will be of a lot of use. Apparently we need to open that though. And by climbing up through that shaft, we make it to this next section. Which is Ravenholm, where we were told not to go to. But I end up doing anyway. Because there's lots of headcrabs here. And the result of that. Is that we can use the gravity gun to pretty much haul these circular saws around, oh boy. And use them for our purposes. Oh boy. Oh shit. And also throw explosives around. I could have sworn that they all would have exploded there, but I guess not. So if we do this in a certain way, we can pretty much get through this whole part with only the gravity gun. Now where did that thing go? Also, I'm pretty sure the headcrabs are pretty much the only enemies that are directly vulnerable to the blast from the gravity gun. Also, that thing bounces all over the place once you throw it. There it is. And we're not quite alone in terms of decent company. Well, there are also these traps, which you can see the purpose they serve. And we can certainly use them to our advantage. If we just hang back. Yeah, we can also blast this thing with the gravity gun to make it go if it's not functioning. And we don't want to turn it on outright.
So, hang on a minute, actually, before I proceed. I need to examine this for just a second. And maybe take a bite too, hang on. Do I have the music player open right now? No, I don't, because the fucking power cut that forced me to restart. So, give me a few minutes for a quick, quick pseudo intermission. Right.
thought I windowed something by accident, but no. It's pretty much all I wanted to look. So it's time to resume with this chapter. This survival horror type chapter with the gravity gun and circular sauce and zombies all around. Seems like that would be faster with an explosion, but that's also the hazard of blowing you up as well. Oh wait. But that's why you have caches to relieve you. Also, that crow is flying in place. It's kind of stuck, it seems. Ah, there he goes. Well, there he is. Helping out, kind of. Alright, so that guy is pretty much the only non-zombified resident of the town. And he set this whole place up with traps, and other things to help proceed. And help fight the apparently never-ending horde of zombies, but you can use that to your advantage. Oh boy. And at least there's quite a few supplies lying around, pretty much like everywhere else. Except a few places. And the way that these gas traps work, I guess. Yes, you turn on the gas and then you light it. But if you need to get through, you just turn off the gas. But then again, you can pretty much use that to help you get past all this. And we need to go that way, but the fence is electrified, so we can't really do anything about that right now, or get that guy out of the way. So we check out the inside of the building. Oh boy. Of headcrabs are a persisting obstacle, but that's enough to not warrant the use of the gravity gun. Apparently all those things blew up. All that furniture just exploded as we walked through it. Oh boy. But then sometimes the headcrabs survive, even after you chop the bodies that they possess in half. I remember the time they just lie there and you think that
they're not gonna get up, but they always do. Also, there's a couple varieties of headcrab in this level. And that was a poison headcrab. They are awful, because if they hit you like that one just did, they reduce your health to 1. And then it slowly goes back up. So it pretty much puts you in mortal danger for a short time. Also, we just turned off the electricity. And if I interpreted the document right, this is where the next... about where the next cache should be. Oh, there it is. Well, there's a symbol at least. And now there's more poison headcrabs going around. So I guess it's up there. Maybe. Maybe it's in that vent. Oops. So presumably we would need to get on top of this thing to get over there, but... just a little tricky. Maybe we should try to get rid of this vent cover that's in here. Or maybe we cannot. Alright. And there we are. But now that we've gone ahead and made it through that building and turn off the electricity, we can proceed in this direction. I guess we're not doing a good enough job for that then. But we are vigilant enough to know which way is the way ahead. These guys take forever to die with the gravity gunshot. But I'm still doing it. So let's see. This next section we got cars that smash down our straps. To be demonstrated in a moment here. Well, that could have gone a bit better, and there was a symbol for the next thing just up ahead. That cart going down. There we go. And there we go. And using this cars not only as traps but as a means to get high. High above everything and perhaps high in a certain other sense, as you will feel if you play this game for long enough like I have. Should be able to make it past that fence there, which leads to the cache. There we go.
There we go. And that leaves only one more in this particular section of the level. Now to get out. Well, I would imagine this, but oh, there we go. But since that's pretty much as far as we can go in this street, we do have to use the cars as a way to get above. And keep going. Keep going in, oh, over there, I guess. Could also go over there. Is there anything over here? Yeah, there's a way into a building.
Better and better. I am Father Grigori. You have already met my congregation.
Well, alright, I guess we do have to go that way. So let's see. Up here is a fast headcrab, or there was a fast headcrab. Which is, yeah, the only thing. I think this is pretty much the only place they show up for, I recall. Poison headcrabs and the fast headcrabs. Yep, I've been using nothing but. But the gravity gun. See, I can use bricks and paint cans to kill the headcrabs as well. Oh. And I didn't realize that those guys were there. I was wondering where you went. And there's more of them below. Was this guy like? Yeah, of course he is. Well, so much for using those gas tanks. My thought is that one didn't catch fire somehow. Oh well. Oh boy. Thought there was gonna be more than one explosion there. Option. Well, I went below sooner than I was expecting. But it works out. Since you can just throw stuff around and use that, sure means to kill everything. And in one of these rooftops, there should be another one. So we need to find a ladder. Or some other way to get up. There it is.